Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Quran Weekly, this is your brother Umar Suleiman. You know, a lot of times when we talk about Jannah, one of the issues that we have is that we really don't work for it. And working for it is actually the last thing that you should be doing. The first thing that you should be doing is wanting it. And if I really asked you, do you really want Jannah? Obviously everyone wants Jannah, but how bad do you want it? And subhanAllah, sometimes wanting it is enough to take you to the next level. Rasulullah ﷺ once, for example, was telling the Sahaba about a group, an elite group on the Day of Judgment who will enter Jannah without any form of adab, without any form of hisab. No accountability, no questions asked, no punishment whatsoever. And one of the companions that was sitting there by the name of Ukasha radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he immediately jumped up and he said, Ya Rasulullah, du'u Allah an akuna minhum. O Messenger of Allah, make dua that I'm one of them. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Anta minhum. You are one of them. Then another sahabi said, oh wait, so this is what it's all about, right? So another sahabi jumped up and he said, Ya Rasulullah, me too. He said, Sabaqaka biha Ukasha. Ukasha beat you to it. So sometimes just wanting Jannah, really thinking about it, how much do you want Jannah? How much do you want the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So the first step, we're going to go through a three-step program, inshallah, to attain Jannah. It's called want, ask, act. Want, ask, act. You want it, and then you ask for it. Now someone might say, well, what good does it mean to ask for it? You know, what's that going to do? There's a very beautiful hadith, and if there is one thing I want you to apply from this video, it's this one, inshallah. There is one very beautiful hadith which is narrated in Sunan al-Tirmidhi and also in Muslim Imam Ahmad with an authentic chain from Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ سَأَلَ اللَّهُ الْجَنَّةِ ثَلَاثَ مَرَّاتِ. Whoever asks Allah for Jannah three times, not only does Allah answer the dua, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Jannah actually talks. Jannah speaks. قَالَتِ الْجَنَّةِ اللَّهُمَّ أَدْخِلُهُ الْجَنَّةِ. Jannah itself makes dua to Allah, O Allah, enter him into paradise. And the Prophet ﷺ said, وَمَنْ سَأَلَ اللَّهُ and whoever asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protection from hellfire, الْعِذْقَ مِنَ النَّارِ وَفِي رِوَايَةِ الْجَارَ مِنَ النَّارِ, to be protected from hellfire, to be guarded from hellfire. Hellfire makes dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اللَّهُمَ أَجِرْهُ مِنَ النَّارِ. O Allah, protect him from the fire. SubhanAllah, asking three times, if you can just incorporate this one thing in your life. If you want Jannah, why don't you just say so? Allahumma adkhilni al-jannat al-firdaus. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, don't just ask for Jannah, ask for the highest level, which is in his companionship, inshaAllah, in the highest level of paradise, with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you make dua three times. Look how easy it is. Allahumma adkhilni al-jannat al-firdaus. Allahumma adkhilni al-jannat al-firdaus. Allahumma adkhilni al-jannat al-firdaus. Oh Allah, grant me paradise. You ask it three times. If you just did that, paradise just made dua for you. And do the same for hellfire, and hellfire will make dua for you to not enter it, inshaAllah. And the last thing, so we have want, ask, act. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كُلَّ أُمَّتِ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا مَنْ أَبَى. Every single person will enter paradise except for the one who refuses. Can you imagine that? Everyone will enter paradise except for the one who refuses. SubhanAllah. So Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, how could we possibly refuse Jannah? The Prophet ﷺ said, by obeying him ﷺ and following his sunnah, you are on the path to Jannah. By disobeying the Prophet ﷺ and neglecting his sunnah, you are refusing to enter Jannah. Because Allah gave you the path, Allah gave you the guide. You don't have to sit there and wonder, man, how do I get there? What stock do I invest in? How do I do this? Where I do, you know, how do I do that? Every single venture that you take, business venture in this life, has a risk to it. Jannah has no risk. You follow the Prophet ﷺ, you're in. It's fitrah to go home. You're from there anyway. You're in. So three things, just three steps again. Repeat them with me, inshaAllah ta'ala. Want it, ask for it, act for it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a jannah to firdaus and to protect us from the hellfire. Allahumma ameen. Jazakum Allah khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Quran Weekly. So do yourself a favor. If you benefited from this video, go ahead and like it and share it on your Facebook and Twitter. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, as is narrated in Sahih Muslim, مَنْ سَنَّ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ سُنَّةً حَسَنَةً فَلَهُ أَجْرُ وَأَجْرُ مَنْ عَمَلَ بِهَا, that whoever does something good, inshaAllah ta'ala, and starts it, or shares it, and other people follow, then he will get the reward that he has, and of course the reward of anyone who followed him in that, inshaAllah. So if someone else benefits from this, you get the same reward as the presenter, inshaAllah, and the same reward as the producer. So go ahead and like it, love it, share it. Jazakum Allah khayran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.